so to speak. Oh,
okay. Well, I think we're going to get there, and we're going to see that they probably saw each other. There's probably my pops and Mrs. Q.
No.
Oh,
no.
I know. There's going to be body parts scattered all over the croissant.
Grandfather would insist on coffee and orange juice before shedding blood.
Oh, where's my jacket? Where's my jacket? No.
Look on your arm.
Oh, okay. Maybe they didn't. They didn't kill each other. Okay, maybe. But here, look in there. If I see a police cruiser in the driveway, I am gonna expect
Lois.
The worst. Let's go. Come on. We heard voices.
Oh, good morning. Come in, please.
Morning.
Oh, yes, you. Yes.
Morning.
Yes.
You?
You're in the right place. And normally we have breakfast in the den, but Lila is redecorating. As a matter of fact, she's on the phone with London right now, making a bid on some Biedermeier furniture.
What the hell does he think he's doing?
He's referring to the chairman of the Federal Reserve. He and Edward went to school together, and Edward takes it as a personal affront every time Mr. Greenspan starts to tinker with the interest rate. Well, do help yourself to juice or coffee. Reginald will be in to take your breakfast order, and the sky is the limit. Waffles, pancakes, omelets, smoked salmon.
No eggs. Bad for his cholesterol.
Oh, Father's chafing under the same dietary restrictions.
What do you doctors know?
That's exactly what Carmine says.
Yes, I'm still here. I'll open at £8,000 for the lot.
I still think you'd do better by the piece.
I'd be on the phone all morning. Besides, they went to a great deal of trouble to rearrange things for me. $9,000.
Oh, hold back for Pete's sake. Just slip in under the hammer.
I'm doing this, Edward. $9,500.
Oh, God.
You know it's worth three times that amount.
How much is that in the dollars?
About 16,000.
Has she ever even seen stuff?
Well, the auction houses, notify their regular clients when there's going to be a sale. And if the people are interested, they send photographs.
10,000.
You're pushing up the bidding.
Oh, go back to complaining about poor Mr. Greenspan. 11.
Would you look at this? This just looks just like Aunt Rose's furniture.
Yeah, and Rosie couldn't wait to sell it to the junk man after she inherited from her in-laws.
This stuff is valuable?
Oh, it's quite the rage these days, yes.
What's happening?
They've jumped to 12,500. 13. Now it's stalled. 13.25. Going once, going twice. £14,000. I got it.
Well done.
Quartermain, yes. You have our account number. And I'd like to arrange for complete, immediate air express shipment to the United States.
Well done, Mother.
Over 20 grand for a bunch of old furniture. She never even sat on.
What's Lois been reading on with people who take interest rates personally and buy 20 grand worth of furniture over the phone?
She isn't in love with the furniture.
Morning.
Hi. How is everybody?
Okay so far. You wouldn't believe what just happened.
Yeah?
Yeah. They bought Aunt Rose's furniture.
20 grand.
Over the phone without ever seeing it. Aunt Rose, she died 2 years ago.
Oh, yes, thank God. God rest her soul. She'd have a fit if she knew what that furniture was really worth.
So, did you have a good night's rest?
Fair.
I was hoping we could fit in a round of golf, but they're forecasting a spring snow next time.
You play golf, Carmine? What's your handicap?
The way he swings his club.
That's what they say about me.
I don't bother with a handicap.
Well, if you don't have a handicap, how do people know if you're any good?
Ask me.
For heaven's sake, you can't just walk onto a course and announce that you have no handicap. They'll think that you're either a rank beginner or that you're going to cheat.
Cheat?
Yeah, that's how he and his buddies justify spending only about 10% of their time on the golf course and the other 90% in the bar analyzing the handicaps.
Me? I just Hit the ball.
Next time, for sure.
Brenda, Miguel, and Lily are going to meet us at the gatehouse in about an hour, and then we're going to go over to see Mary Maya at the ward house. Oh, just wait until you meet her kids.
So we'll grab a quick lunch somewhere, and then we'll head on a tour of Port Charles.
You'll find the name Quartermain is ubiquitous.
Yeah, and then back here to change for dinner and dancing at Luke's as Sonny's guests.
The whole family's invited.
Yeah.
I think that Monica and I are going to decline with regret.
I adore Luke's new place.
Not to mention Luke. He flirts with you shamelessly.
Edward and I accept with pleasure. It'll be great fun.
Yeah, well, I think you should find a professional for my part. We don't want to make you feel pressured to be in the video. I just think that it's going to take a lot more than being myself.
If you're not going to do it, you better start telling Lois.
Yeah, we don't want to make you feel pressured to be in the video. I just think that it's going to take a lot more than being myself.
If you're not going to do it, you better start telling Lois.
Yeah, we...
Tell Lois what? Hi, guys!
Mom?
Yes?
Gloria Carmine, God. I'd like to introduce the B of LNB, Brenda Barrett.
Nice to meet you.
Yeah, B also stands for best friend. And this is Lily Rivera, our friend Lily. And Miguel's fiancé. And, of course, last but not least, the man himself. Miguel Marez.
Oh, yeah.
We love your music. We listen to your CD all the time, even at breakfast.
Yeah, you're right. You're one darn fine musician.
Oh, thank you very much. And you have a darn fine manager as a daughter. And one of my favorite human beings also.
Oh, mine too, huh, sweetheart? And you, Brenda, you have been a very, very good friend to my Lois.
Oh, well, I've let her down a few times, but she always manages to forgive me. You two have an amazing... daughter, you know that.
Well, I'm glad you appreciate her.
Oh, we do. Believe me.
She knows how to pick them, most of the time.
No, she knows how to bring out the best in people.
That's for sure.
You're all embarrassing me.
So this is your company headquarters?
Yeah, the studio is in there, and this is like the reception area / my living room, living room.
Yeah, and these right here, these are the storyboards for Miguel's new video.
Yeah, which Ned is financing, Pops, out of the goodness of his heart. Financing it.
And because I have a keen eye for a fellow artist talent.
Come on, now you are generous on both counts, you know.
We may have a problem. Just a little one. Lily is a little uncomfortable with the concept of being in the video, so I think maybe we might need to rethink.
Oh, well, no. Of course you're nervous. That's how I know you're going to be so good. You think Miguel here isn't swatting bullets? Listen. Anybody who tells you they're going into something like this with total confidence is either handing you a load of bull or doesn't have a real emotion inside of themselves to be interesting on camera. I will not let you make a fool out of yourself. Word of honor.
I'm an amateur.
But a pro might try to make a video about her. But you and Brenda will let Miguel shine.
Come on, we need you. You're a part of this team.
She's good at this.
That's our girl.
Anybody home?
Come on in.
We decided to take you at your word when you said drop by any time. Hi, cousin.
Oh, it appears that some explanations are in order. All in good time.
Oh, Ma and Pops, Carmine and Gloria, I'd like you to meet Mary May Ward, jazz and blues singer extraordinaire and the heart and soul of the Bradley Ward House, where kids learn what love's all about.
And we learn from them.
Yeah,
isn't that the truth?
Yeah.
Welcome. This is my granddaughter, Keisha.
Hello.
And this is my grandson, Justice.
Hi, pleasure to meet you.
Justice is a city councilman.
Really?
Mm-hmm. Any chance we can get the nickel tour?
Well...
Dang it!
Oh, hey! This is Brian!
Hi, Brian!
All right, well, follow us.
Okay.
Right,
Brian? Right. Thank you.
Ned, Jason told me that you gave the okay for us to go to Paris on the Quartermain jet. Thank you.
I hope you have a wonderful trip.
Well, we still have a few obstacles to overcome.
Where there's a will, there's a way.
Right.
You certainly have made a wonderful home here.
Oh, imagine where these kids would be without Mary May.
Really just wonderful.
As soon as we get back to Brooklyn, I'm sending you some stuff from the store.
Oh.
baseball bats, gloves, soccer balls. I'll even send you some of those snow saucer things for sledding.
Oh, thank you. We're very grateful. We make every dollar count around here.
Yeah, well, L&B is donating a portion of our proceeds from Mary May's new CD to the Ward House.
I'm going to set up a display case at Guts and Glory. That's my store. To sell L&B product. We'll push your CD very hard.
Yeah.
Once people hear it, word of mouth will take care of the rest. Okay. Ready for lunch?
Oh, wait. It seems like we just had breakfast.
I'm starved.
Will you join us, Mary May? Justice, Keisha, you too?
No, I'm sorry, I can't.
Neither can I.
And I have something to discuss with Justice. Well, if you guys change your mind, then please join us at the Outback, okay?
Okay.
I think we should eat at the Port Charles Grill.
No, it's too formal. Besides, the Outback has burgers that are to die for.
Okay, fine. In that case, I better call and make reservations.
What? Mac will find us a table.
Better safe than sorry. You get everyone set on the car, and I'll make a quick phone call.
Okay. Hello?
Hi, this is Ned Ashton. Is Mac around?
Oh, hi, Ned. It's Robin. Mac's busy right now. Can you call you back?
Give him a message for me. Tell him that I'm on my way over to the Outback with Lois and her parents. You got that?
No problem. We have plenty of tables.
Just be sure you tell Mac that we'll be there.
Will do. See you soon.
Right. Lois and her parents.
Got it.
Oh, Mac, Ned Ashton called earlier and he said that he was bringing Lois's parents to lunch here.
When?
Now, they just walked in.
Oh. Hey.
Oh, by all means, that's you all. Hey, Mac, how you doing? Mac?
Mac.
Hi.
Hi. Welcome to the Outback.
Thank you.
Hey, I know you. You're the guy who came into my store asking all those questions about Sonny Correntos. Huh? What do you work here?
Actually, I own the place. Max Scorpio. And you must be Lois's beautiful mother, Gloria.
Well, thank you.
You're very welcome.
Wait a minute. When were you in Bensonhurst?
A couple of months back.
You didn't tell my pops who you were?
Actually, he didn't ask.
Yeah, but you were pumping him about Sonny. I mean, pops. This guy's also a private investigator.
He didn't mention that.
So who's having Sonny investigated? Huh? I mean, who are you working for?
Myself.
Sure you are.
It's true. Lois, look, things were heating up between Robin and Stone. And, look, I didn't want her hanging around Corinthos. So I was trying to get some ammunition to you so she'd steer clear. I mean, if not of Stone, at least his boss.
So who sent you to my father?
I heard it mentioned that that you and Sonny went to school together. So I thought Bensonhurst was the best place to start. I knew your dad's name. I knew he ran a sporting goods store. I mean, it's not that hard to track down. Everybody in the neighborhood knows Carmine.
That's true enough.
Look, I'm sorry if I stepped on anyone's toes, but hey, you didn't tell me anything I didn't pretty much know already.
I don't know why this should surprise me.
Don't start, Robin. Okay, it's history. It's behind us now.
You invaded my privacy and Sonny's, and now Mr. Cerullo? I apologize for my uncle.
Robin, I do my own apologizing.
Listen, I raise teenage daughters. It's a stressful business.
Yeah, for the daughters, too.
Yeah, God willing, they grow up and make you proud. Like my Lois over here.
Oh, Pop. Sweet. See, it can happen.
Yeah, well, I'll believe it when it does. Table for four?
Okay. This is a very lovely place. Oh, Ma, wait till you see the menu. It's a beautiful menu.
Thanks, pal. I owe you one.
And you will pay.
No, don't. You can't have cheese. Your cholesterol is in trouble.
You know what? You can't have the cheesecake either. I know.